Hi, y'all. How's everybody doing today? It's a gorgeous day in Central North Carolina. We're in November. Yeah, like I think we are about 10 days away from Thanksgiving. This year for Thanksgiving, we are really proud. Proud, and feeling patriotic, frankly, to be able to say that we are doing Thanksgiving this year here. He is going to enjoy his Thanksgiving, right, Norman? Yeah. It's just gonna be me and my husband here in our house. And our kids will be in their homes and our grandkids will be in their homes. We are proud to be saying that we are not going to be getting together as a family for this Thanksgiving. One second. Okay, so I'm back. Sorry about that. But I had to give Norman a little bit of a puppy passy, which is a toy filled with peanut butter. Hopefully he'll be quiet for a couple minutes because today's vlog is pantry organization and the amazing stuff that I was able to find to organize the pantry. I also have a fun new purchase that I'm gonna get the purchase for you here. I was so super excited to get this. I ordered this all the way from Merry Old England or Merry Old London, something like that. Anything from England, I am going to purchase because A, it's almost always made just beyond well, made very well. It's always presented so beautifully. This envelope is where Colin Cooper puts the invoice. So this box, this beautiful box, is what my item came in. The shipping box says, I would personally like to thank you for shopping with Holland Cooper. I hope you love your purchase. Best wishes, Jade Holland Cooper. So Jade Holland Cooper, I purchased your amazing item because I just think your style, your manufacturing, your attention to detail, your ability to combine the great British outdoor vibe, you know, the plaids and the canvases, the heavy fabrics with the faux furs. You blend this great British countryside vibe with a modern cool vibe, and that's not easy to do. I love this company. Jade, let me know if I can wear any of your things online for you. And so what I got was, let me see if I can get ready. Pow! This is the most amazing cap. I'm telling you, this is gonna be the hat I wear every day, all through fall and into winter and in spring and into summer and back into fall again. Y'all, look how great. It's kind of like, you see, it's not all the way to the edge. Like a lot of caps that we see here in the US have this style, which is fine, but it's like, they're everywhere and you don't get to see that sort of vintage feel of the cap, which is if you look at history and photographs from pre-war, black and white photographs, you'll see this, which is what this is called, a Baker Boy cap. This Baker Boy, you see it a lot on the paper boys. And I don't know if it's always in tweed. This one's in tweed. And, you know, I don't know if you could wear it backwards. Oh, yeah. Oh, it's cute backwards. Let me see if I can snip off the tag here. Ah! Okay. It's not going back. Okay, let's see. How cute is that? Oh my gosh, that is so cute. Y'all. And so this cap is sort of slouchy. And so you can see close up this great tweed material. This is also 100% wool. Okay, kind of bright there. On the inside, there is an amazing, I mean, the British just do such an amazing job with their branding. Look at the inside, it's fully lined in satin. It's all the way lined, all the way to the edge, and then a ribbon, grosgrain ribbon, has been sewn around the edge. That is just a little bit of makeup from where I have put it on here and there. This is a small. They also come in medium and large. So I just love this cap. It's gonna be hard for me to shoot the rest of this video without it. So I can wear it with my hair behind my ears. Okay, so like that. Or I can wear it with just a top like that. And you know, any old which way I put it down, it looks great. So I just love the fact that you have this kind of, almost like this baseball bill here, and the rest of it's sort of slouchy. So you end up having this kind of slouchy fabric, but it's not slouchy sloppy. It's slouchy cool. So again, I think I might just wear it. I'm just gonna wear it. I'm gonna wear it. Okay. So that is today's amazing unboxing from Holland Cooper. Oh my gosh. This was, I think, 75 pounds, which was 101 American dollars. So I figured this is classic. I will wear this for the rest of my life, and I will pass it down to my son and grandsons or my nephews, and they will wear it, because this style, as I said earlier, I mean, people have been wearing this style for 100 years. So I decided actually that I'm going to take it off because I don't want it to get dirty. Not yet anyway. Okay, so we're going to talk today about organizing the closet, and we're gonna do it with IKEA baskets. Look at here, these baskets, y'all. I got three of these baskets. Peekaboo. I got three of these baskets because I knew what I had to organize. You ready? That is what I have to organize. I'm gonna take you off your stand, and I'm gonna take you a little closer in so you can see. Dear Lord. Oh, my goodness. In fact, I'm going to take you off altogether and put you on a different tripod so you can get real close in. Okay, so you can see that I have cleaned out mostly this shelf right here and kind of just tidied so that I can see what I have. What I have had to do, I'm gonna turn you around here. What I've had to do is to, one of these days I'm gonna get like an actual real tripod. I hope you don't fall over. So what I've had to do was to kind of spread everything out. This was everything that was on that shelf, okay? So I'm a little bit overwhelmed with with how I'm gonna organize this. So I have my three baskets here. I'm gonna move you just a little bit closer so you can see. Sorry for my hand being in the way here. Boop, 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 boop. And of course, Norman is, Norman is in the way. Bless him, as he always is. Okay, sorry about all the adjustment, but I just don't have all the fancy equipment. Okay, one second. Okay, so I have my Ziploc bags. Undo my thing here. I have all my Ziploc bags right here in case I need to. That was Norman just going underneath the cable and giving me like a minor heart attack because he, right before my meeting, he went underneath my desk over here and got caught in the cables and just cleared everything off the top of my desk right before my meeting. Isn't that fun? Okay. So I have everything ready to go, and I have my baskets over here, one, two, three. I measured these, and I'll put the link in the description box below. I measured these, I measured the shelf first, and then checked the IKEA site for the right size and depth, because I didn't want to get too deep, because I wanted to be able to see somewhat the kind of the top of the basket, so when I look into the cupboard, you know, I want to be able to see a little bit what's inside. I also don't want it spilling over the side, so they had to be, you know, the right depth, not too shallow, not too deep. So these are, again, I'll put the link below, but these are excellent. As soon as I start talking, these are an excellent width and depth. Okay. So, okay. Hopefully he'll stop in a second. All right. So first I'm going to go through the breads. So here are the breads. This is bakery sourdough bread. You know, you have too much. Gracious. Sweet Norman is on my last nerve today. You know you have too much bread when you can't even pick up the bread without dropping everything. Okay, so now this is an old hamburger bun. That's gone bad, so that's going out. Okay, so I am going to put these in here in such a way that I can see what I have. Now this, Norman, this rye bread is almost gone, so I'm gonna put it in the front of the new bag so that when my husband likes this rye, I don't understand the rye bread, I really don't. If you understand rye bread, put it in the comments below, because I don't get it. It tastes like bread with like gasoline soaked in it or something. It just, ugh. Yeah, if you understand rye, put it in the comments below. So the new bag goes in the back and the existing old or, you know, it's already being used. That goes in the front, okay? So put it in there like that. And then this is my oat nut bread. This is actual real bread. This isn't that, whatever that rye bread stuff is. So I put this in the front. This is not a new bag. I've only taken a few pieces out of that. And then the sourdough bread, I just sort of tuck along on the side. Now I'm not gonna put that in the cupboard just yet because I may still want to organize it in such a way that doesn't mean I want to go back in there and dig that back out. Okay. So this nuts. Okay. So the rest of this pile is nuts. We're going nuts here. These are pistachios. Now this is a Christmas gift from last year. So I'm not really sure what to do about this one, so I'm gonna put it over here. This is a brand new bag of edamame. These are snacks. They're not really nuts, but they're nut-like. And these two things are peanut powder. I use this to mix in my drink mix, my smoothie shake. And also, I put a couple of tablespoons of peanut powder in when I'm baking because it gives the end result, it gives it kind of a moistness and a kind of a structure. Ooh, he just went underneath the cable. I don't know how he does that. Sometimes he pulls it down and other times he doesn't. He didn't just then. Okay, hopefully he's going to take a nap. Okay, so all of these, this powder is great for baking. So technically, as I was just saying, it makes it nice and moist. Technically, this peanut powder could go in with the baking items, but I'm not gonna do that. I'm gonna make a miscellaneous basket. So this basket is gonna be bread. This basket is gonna be nuts. And this basket is gonna be miscellaneous. Okay, so the peanut powder is gonna go in the miscellaneous basket. The rest are So these are all nuts. These pistachios and soy nuts are also gonna go into the miscellaneous basket because they're kind of miscellaneous. Now these nuts are very old. I've had these since, gosh, probably February or even March. So depending on if these are stale or not, I might put these out in the woodland for the birds and the other creatures that are out there. I may also put some of these nuts out there as well. These are a mix of raw almonds and these Blue Diamond Smokehouse almonds. As well in here is the vinegar and salt almonds from Blue Diamond also. So I mix those in so that I get a lower quantity of sodium. And these also are, they're also prepared in a vegetable oil. So I mix the raw almonds, which come in this big Costco bag. I mix these two together so that I reduce the sodium and the additional oil that's used to prepare them. Just so they're just a little bit healthier and still yummy and fun to eat. Great snack. Okay, now I am going, now this is a brand new bag of walnuts, but these are almost gone. So what I'm gonna do is I am going to mix these two bags that are raw, not prepared like this. They're just like they came from Mother Nature. I'm gonna mix those into a gallon Ziploc bag. And I like the Ziploc bag, not because I'm somehow wedded to the brand, but I like them because when you have items like sugar, flour, nuts, anything, you know, baking ingredients like chocolate chips, anything like that, which if it's not sealed properly or contained properly, if it spills, it goes everywhere and you spend the next hour cleaning your kitchen. Those kinds of items are much better in a bag where you can see that it is closed. So when it spills, you don't have a question as to whether the bag is sealed or not. Some of those other zip style bags, I personally do not always know if it is sealed fully. So it's just me. It's not, I'm not saying one type of bag is better than another or one brand is better than another. But for me personally, because I seem to always struggle to get the zipper closed, I like this because zip, it's open, zip, it's closed. Okay. Now, I am going to take a marker and I'm going to put the date on here. Now, I should have done this beforehand, but I was a little bit excited to get everything organized. And so, unfortunately, I didn't have my list ahead of time to be as organized as I would like to be. But the goal is to always work towards getting better, not be better right out of the gate, because then what would be the use? You're always, always working to do things better. We're always learning something every day. Okay, so I'm gonna put on here the date. Let's see. Sometimes these bags will have a date and a contents, but this one doesn't. So I'm just gonna put November. What's the date today? The 18th? The 19th? November 18th, 2020. What a year. Okay. And I'm gonna use the Sharpie pen because these things are great in the freezer, in the cupboard. They don't rub off as well and they go really well on the plastic, okay? So this is going in the front of the nut basket. These are pecans, walnuts. These are going in the nut basket. Now that I have those in there, I am thinking that I might store them in the freezer because when you store, I just got these out of the freezer. When you store these, you can see, look how cold they are. They're frosty. When you store these in the freezer, what happens is they instantly stop any growth of bacteria or any staleness, any air that might happen to be in this bag is instantly going to stop doing what it's doing. So it just goes completely dormant. Any bacteria that's in there will go dormant. So, or any mold or anything like that, which, you know, generally you don't see from Costco, but sometimes it can happen. So I like to put any overages or any extras into the freezer right away if I know that they are not going to be used. within a few weeks from the time I bring them home from the store. They'll go straightway into the freezer. So we're gonna do that now. Okay, so stored right in the back of the freezer. No, Norman, no. Don't knock this over, go lay down. Go lay down, over there. Go lay down, okay. So there's a delivery man that's coming down the door, down the driveway, so hopefully he won't bark too loud at that. Okay, so then we take our empty container, our empty bags, throw those away so that we have a clean work surface. Then I have my almonds that are flavored, and I'm gonna put these into the miscellaneous basket because that's really the only place that they are gonna fit. Now, as I said earlier, I'm thinking about putting these out into the woodlands for the birds and some of the other animals that live around here. I don't know if you can see, but we're on about 3 acres here in central North Carolina. So we have quite a few critters out there. Okay, so I am going to put these away and I'm gonna put you on fast forward while I tidy up just a little bit, okay? I'll see you on the other side. Okay, so you can see that it is much tidier than it was before. I'm real proud of that. I was real excited to get those IKEA baskets. And again, I think I'm gonna go ahead and order some more of those because look how perfectly they fit on the shelf. I mean, I'm just so pleased with that. I don't know if you can see. Yeah, you can see. Okay, so over here in the corner, and of course, down here, we have the inspector. Do we pass inspection? Yes? Y'all, puppies. I mean, they just keep you so busy. I had a few of those nuts. Excuse me. Okay, so again, we've got things grouped here, canned goods, cooking items down here, so those flour and sugar. There's also a container where I keep my paper napkins because generally, I don't know if you've ever seen paper goods. When you open the container, they just, you know, once you get them home from the store and you unwrap them, the stuff just goes everywhere. So I like to keep those in a, okay. We have a counter surfer. Puppies. Normally I would discipline him for that, but because I couldn't put my tripod down fast enough, I didn't want to discipline him even a second later than necessary. You have to get them right away or they won't understand why they're being disciplined. Okay, so back to my, I'm gonna put my tripod down on the ground here. Tilt you up just a little bit. Okay, so again, yes, I know, go lay down. Gracious. The best vloggers out in the world probably don't have dogs and cats running around. They have an assistant who's keeping them downstairs. Okay, no. Look, there you go. Okay, so down here, gracious, stop it. You're gonna go in your house. Okay, so down here, we still have this bag of potatoes and this bag of onions. What am I gonna do with these, y'all? What am I gonna do? I also have this bag. Is this not the best storage possible? So now these are beginning to grow their roots and things. And these were organic sweet potatoes. They're really delicious. And you see that the skin around them is still tight. So this potato, the skin on it has become wrinkly. That means it's dehydrated. And you can see, I'm not sure if you can see, but it is very soft. You can see it's really kind of giving way to my fingers there. And this is still quite firm. So even though this has roots coming out of it, these are the eyes. The roots are coming out of what we call the potato eye. So this right here is the beginning of a potato eye, okay? This can still be used because it is firm, it's not dehydrated, and it, when you cut it open, it still will be moist and not dehydrated and not basically beginning to decompose. So this sweet potato is still usable. So I'm gonna hang on to that. This one needs to go into the composter because it is dehydrated. It is just almost unusable. The sugars in this potato have increased so much that I probably can't even make mashed potatoes from this because it will be so sticky because the sugars have increased so much. Okay. Can dogs eat onions? I don't know. Somebody look that up. Okay, back up. Okay. So we're gonna have to look at this a little bit later and see, most of it's probably going in the composter or in the woodland. Okay. Now, these are a bag of brand new potatoes. So I'm gonna put these to the side because I can use those anytime. And this is a brand new bag of onions as well. So these are going okay, Norman, out. Gracious. So this bag is useless. I'm gonna toss that into the recycling. I'm gonna vacuum later. Okay. Out.
The hunt for a basket for my potatoes and onions got kind of long, so I'm going to voice this over and let you know what we ended up doing. We found a container, you and I together, and I put all my potatoes and carrots into the container and into the pantry. I vacuumed and tidied up. I didn't want to add all that extra video in order to keep this vlog a little bit on the shorter side. Thank you so much for watching today. Don't forget to subscribe and ring the bell so you know when I post again.